Hey, welcome to Hat Day. We finally made it to Friday, thank goodness. I had a lot of people turn in answers for the math. Aiden T was really killing it. He did a couple of fact families. He did the balanced equations too, where you had one number plus one number equals another number plus another number, making the same number on both sides of the fraction. And even did one of his own math problems, so that was really good. So, Aiden T also answered, but he asked me some questions. So that's kind of cool. One of the questions he asked is, what is your favorite sport? My favorite sport is, has anything to do with car racing. When I was younger, my dad had a car and we raced it. And when I got older, I helped build the car and would drag race that car on a drag strip down in Bremerton, Washington, small town. So that's definitely my favorite sport. I love cars and car racing. Favorite, and he also asked, what is your favorite food? Hot wings. I love me some hot wings, and since we've been locked down since March 13th, I haven't had a single hot wing. I'm dying here. All right, but hopefully I'll get a hot wing soon. And the last question Aiden asked, what is your favorite color? Hard one, but I'm gonna probably say black or purple. I kind of go back and forth on the two. I wear more black, but cars, I love purple cars because I'm really weird. I don't know why, I'm just really weird. So, those are the answers to my questions. Anyone else have any questions they want to ask? Feel free, have some fun, make them goofy questions too. I like answering silly stuff. All right, also on our math, Chloe's been doing really good, and she's got a teeny bit behind, but she caught up pretty quick. So thanks so much, Chloe. And guys, I really appreciate all your hard work on this. I know a lot of this stuff is not easy. Let's get to some jokes. How do you fix a cracked pumpkin? With a pumpkin patch! What do you call a funny mountain? Hilarious! Because it's a hill. Why do bees have sticky hair? Because they use a honey comb. I love that one. All right, enough with our shout outs and jokes. And guys, remember, if I didn't get you on a shout out, it's only because I film these a day ahead of time. That's just because it takes so long to edit and upload to YouTube and all that silly stuff. So if I didn't get you this time and you submitted something, I will get you next time. And if I skip you or forget you for some reason, send me an email saying, hey, Mr. Michelson, I missed my shout out. I'll give you a shout out, I promise. All right. Let's talk. Junie B. Jones and some sneaky piggies by. Yes, right. All right. We left off with chapter two, or we did chapter one, sneaky peeky spying. Moving on to chapter two, questions. And that's on page 11, according to our fancy table of contents. Chapter two, questions. Me and my bestest friend Lucille sit at my same table together. My table is where I sit up straight and do my work and don't talk to my neighbor. Except I keep forgetting that don't talk to my neighbor part. I wonder where Mrs. lives, I whispered to Lucille real quiet. Shh, said Lucille. We can't talk or else we'll get in trouble. And anyways, you're not allowed to know where she lives because it's a secret. Says who, I asked. Says my brother, that's who. And he's in third grade. And he says teachers have to keep their house a secret or else kids might go there and throw rotten tomatoes. Yeah, only I don't want to throw tomatoes, Lucille. I just want to hide in her hamper, and that's all. Well, I don't care, she said. You're still not allowed, because my brother said so. And he knows more than you do. So there. I made an angry face at her. So there is not a nice word, Lucille, I said. Then I made my fist at her, except for Missa saw me, and I had to unfold it. After after that, I behaved myself very good. I sat up real straight and I did all my work. Work is what you do when you use your brain and a pencil. Only sometimes I accidentally use the eraser too hard and a big hole rubs in my paper. Hey, I did beautifully today, I called out, because guess what? No hole, that's what. Mrs. came to my table and she put a gold star on my work. Hey, I should use gold stars, it sounds like fun. You did do beautifully, Junie B, she said. Maybe I'll hang this one on the wall for Grandparents' Day on Monday. Would you like that? Excuse me. Yes, I said, only I kept forgetting how come those guys are coming to this place. Then Mrs. explained to me all about Grandparents' Day again. She said our grandparents are coming for a visit, and we get to show them room 9, and we get to have freshments together. Mrs. said freshments are cookies and a beverage. I raised my hand. Yeah, only I don't think I'm allowed to have the kind of drink named a beverage, because I'm only allowed to have milk and juice, and that's all. Mrs. looked up at the ceiling. I looked up there too, but I didn't see what she was looking at. How many of you think you can bring cookies on Monday? Asked Mrs. I can! I hollered very excited. Because my mother is the bestest cookie baker in the whole entire world. That's why, except for one time, she accidentally forgot that they were in the oven and the firemen had to come to our house because of all the smoke. Mrs. laughed. Only I don't know why, because that was not a funny story. After that, she gave me a note for Mother. It was some writing about baking cookies, I think. If your mother has any questions, please have her call me. Just then I got a great idea. Hey, I said, maybe me and Mother can bring the cookies to your house, and so then I can see where you live. Mrs. rumpled my hair. You don't have to come to my house, Junie B. Just bring the cookies to school on Monday morning. Yeah, only I want to see where you live. Then Mrs. turned around and she walked back to her desk. That's how come I had to follow her. Do you have the rich kind of house or the regular kind of house? I asked her. Because I just have the regular kind of house, except for Mother wants the rich kind, only Daddy says lots of luck. Mrs. pointed at my chair. That means to sit down. Pull it together, class. Yeah, only do you have a daddy that lives at your house too? Are there any pictures in your wallet? Let's look in there, okay? Do you have a secret compartment in your wallet too? Cause my grandpa Miller has one of those things and he has $50 in that secret pocket. Only don't tell grandma. Mrs. took my hand. Then me and her walked back to my table. Yeah, only guess what I'm wondering now. Now I'm wondering what your bedtime is. Cause my bedtime is was when the little hands on the 7 and the big hands on the 6. Only I don't like that dumb bedtime, because I'm not even tired yet, of course. Mrs. put her finger to her lips. That is enough, Junie B, she said. I mean it. I need you to settle down now. Then she went right back to the front of the room, and she did not answer any of my questions. And guess what? Mrs. is a secret mystery guy, that's what. And chapter 3 is called Secret Mystery Guy. We will read that one on Monday. See you then. Hey, welcome to Number Talks. All right, left you guys with this, and I know I had a few people that sent me some answers. A and T had some really good ones. Remember, to solve these, the first thing you gotta do is you have to know what's on one side of the equation. So that 3 + 1 I know is 4, so I need to come up with a subtraction problem that's gonna equal 4, like 6 take away 2. I know that's 4, I can check it, 6, 5, 4. Good. Down here, I got 4 + 2. Now I know 4 + 2 is 6, so I need to come up with a takeaway problem that equals 6. So something like 7 take away 1, that's gonna equal 6. 7 count back 1, 6. And down here on this one, 5 + 5, I'm gonna use Aiden's because he had a really good one. 5 + 5 is 10, so Aiden did 20 take away 10. That's a really good one, and that does equal 10. So for these to work, they must be balanced, the same number on each side, like a balance beam, keeping it straight. So, the equals means the same. We got the same on each side, so these all work. So, we're all set. Instead of doing math problems today, I thought we'd have a little fun. Let's go ahead and get a little crazy and let's try a picture. Now, on your paper, board, whatever you have that you're working on, draw a box about halfway down close to the side. Then on the other side, do another box. Now here's your challenge. Turn that into a picture. You don't have to do this yourself. Get your family involved. Ask older brother, older sister, younger brother, younger sister, mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, aunt, uncle, whoever at your house that you can ask for help. And see what you can do to turn this into a really cool picture. You can use crayons, markers, whatever you have. You can use mud. Don't use mud. Don't. For the love of God, don't use mud. Your parents will kill me. But use whatever you have to draw a really cool picture. Maybe you could turn this into a bridge. Maybe you could turn it into a building, like a city landscape. Maybe you could turn it into a bunch of blocks that kids are playing with. Anything you want, just have some fun with it. Take a picture of it. Send me the picture if you can. I don't have a way to print those pictures out, but what I can do is hold up a Chromebook and we can take a look at them together on Monday. Speaking of Monday, let's do Monday Mitten Day. I saw a little video on YouTube the other day of someone using oven mitts like mittens, and it was pretty funny, so I want to try it because it looks like fun, and I like fun. All right. Thank you guys so much. We will be seeing you again on Monday. Remember, if you want to ask me a question, ask me a question. Keep up the hard work, and see you Monday.